to ascend on high, from down below, with caution, start, and steadily go. Good morning, today is Tuesday, March 12, 2024. Today in history, on this day 200 years ago, German physicist Gustav Robert Kirchhoff was born. He is renowned for proposing two fundamental laws governing electrical circuits, Kirchhoff's current law and Kirchhoff's voltage law. These laws, which describe the relationships between current, voltage, and resistance in steady circuit networks, have been instrumental in solving problems related to electrical appliance design and circuit analysis. Qing Qiao, bridging the business world and delivering information to you. Welcome to today's Qing Qiao Morning News. Let's start with political updates. Haiti's presidential palace, gunfight erupts. According to Xinhua News Agency, on March 8, a significant gun battle erupted near the presidential palace in Port-au-Prince, the capital of Haiti. Philippe, the leader orchestrating the riots, expressed his aspirations to become the president of Haiti and demanded Prime Minister Henry's resignation. He also stated intentions to seek amnesty for certain gang members if assuming leadership. It is reported that Haiti has been grappling with escalating violence and unrest since the assassination of then-President Moïse on July 7, 2021, which left a power vacuum. Gang activity has surged, and crime rates have soared as a result. Originally scheduled before February 7 this year, the national elections were postponed, leading to widespread social discontent. On March 3 this year, armed gangs attacked the national prison in Port-au-Prince and the Croix-de-Bouquet prison, resulting in casualties among police and prison personnel and a significant number of prisoner escapes. In response, a state of emergency was declared in the western province, including Port-au-Prince, accompanied by a curfew imposed by law enforcement agencies. The state of emergency in the western province has been extended until April 3 by the Haitian government, with law enforcement agencies continuing curfew measures to restore local security order. South Korea's intern doctors, 90% remain on strike. Seoul Comprehensive News. Recent reports indicate that South Korea is set to issue notification documents to interns and residents who have not returned to work by the end of February this week. They will be required to submit feedback to the government before March 25, failing which their licenses may be revoked for up to 3 months. As of March 8, approximately 90% of the 13,000 intern doctors in South Korea participating in the strike action have not resumed work. The strike, opposing the expansion of medical school enrollment, is nearing its fourth week with no imminent resolution in sight. Earlier, the government mandated that striking doctors must return to work before February 29, with penalties for non-compliance including license revocation for up to a year, imprisonment for 3 years, or a fine of 30 million won. The Yoon Suk-yeol administration has reiterated its steadfast stance on the healthcare reform plan. The plan entails increasing medical school enrollment from the current 3,058 to 5,000 starting next year. The government argues that this change is vital to address South Korea's severe doctor shortage and support its rapidly aging healthcare system. Secondly, we'll bring you updates on military-related news. U.S. military builds temporary dock in Gaza. Comprehensive news from Gaza. The United States recently announced its intention to provide humanitarian assistance to Gaza through sea routes. Following this announcement, a U.S. Army logistics support ship departed from a base in Virginia to the eastern Mediterranean. The ship is transporting equipment necessary to build a floating dock in the Mediterranean waters outside Gaza. The establishment of this temporary terminal is expected to take 60 days. Initially, the United States plans to utilize facilities in Cyprus to inspect the goods before they are sent to Gaza. Since Israeli officials will also be involved, the goods will not require security inspections upon arrival in Gaza. In addition, the European Union has prepared a maritime humanitarian aid corridor close to Cyprus, the nearest EU member state to Gaza. A ship owned by the Spanish charity Open Arms arrived in Cyprus 3 weeks ago, carrying 200 tons of food. However, its departure to Gaza is pending approval from Israeli authorities. Once approved, this will mark the first aid delivery to Gaza through this maritime corridor. Now, let's turn our attention to the latest economic news. Philippines' unemployment rate rises to 4.5%. Manila News, according to the latest data from the Philippine Statistics Authority, the unemployment rate in the Philippines experienced a significant increase in January this year, rising to 4.5% from a record low of 3.1% in December last year. The number of unemployed individuals surged to 2.15 million, up from 1.6 million in December. Additionally, there was an increase in the number of workers seeking to augment their working hours to boost income, reaching 6.39 million in January, compared to 6.01 million in December last year. Consequently, the underemployment rate rose to 13.9% in January, surpassing the 11.9% recorded in December, indicating a deterioration in the quality of employment in the Philippine job market. Meanwhile, as unemployment rises, there has been a decline in the number of individuals in the labor force aged 15 and above who are actively seeking employment. The labor force in January this year stood at 48.09 million, down from 52.13 million in December. During the same period, the labor force participation rate decreased from 66.6% to 61.1%, indicating a decline in labor market activity. Now, here is some important safety information. Tesla factory halts production after tower fire. Comprehensive news from Berlin: a transmission tower near Tesla's factory in Grünheide, southeast of Berlin, recently caught fire, resulting in the disruption of power supply to the factory and surrounding villages. On the same day, the far-left radical organization Volcano Group claimed responsibility for the arson incident through an open letter, launching an attack on Tesla and CEO Musk. The group criticized Tesla's production activities for depleting the Earth's resources and threatened to completely destroy the Tesla superfactory. The factory's management estimated economic losses to exceed nine figures, with an uncertain restart timeline. The Tesla Gigafactory in Haiti has been a focal point of environmental protests since its establishment 2 years ago. Tesla plans to expand the factory to double its production capacity and increase annual vehicle production to 1 million vehicles to meet the growing demand for electric vehicles in Europe. However, the expansion plan has intensified dissatisfaction among environmentalists, concerned about its potential impact, and raised apprehensions among local residents. New York enhances subway security. Comprehensive news from New York: Governor Hochul recently announced the deployment of 750 additional National Guard troops and 250 police officers to patrol New York City subway stations and conduct bag checks to prevent violence. In recent months, a series of fatal shootings, knife incidents, and incidents involving passengers being pushed onto subway tracks have sparked fear among commuters. Data reveals a nearly 50% increase in major crime incidents in the New York subway in January, compared to the same period in 2023. Hochul also proposed installing new surveillance cameras in conductor cars and urged the state assembly to issue a decree allowing courts to ban attackers from riding the subway. Additionally, efforts will be made to expand the social work team established in January to address the mental health crisis in the subway. Finally, here's some intriguing cultural news. Australia establishes ASEAN Australia Center. According to Lianhe Zaobao News, Australia recently announced the establishment of the ASEAN Australia Center and introduced several measures aimed at enhancing relations with Southeast Asian countries. The ASEAN Australia Center, located in the capital Canberra, will serve as a hub for exchanges between the two regions and facilitate greater understanding of Southeast Asian culture among Australians. The centre is scheduled to open on July 1. Moreover, the Australian Prime Minister's office outlined that the centre will focus on bolstering business, education, cultural, and community ties between Australia, ASEAN member states, and Timor-Leste. Additionally, authorities will introduce over 75 new scholarships and 55 fellowships for students and young leaders from the region. Australia also plans to enhance regional energy policies and planning in collaboration with ASEAN through energy cooperation initiatives. Financial newsletter. In recent London financial news, the international gold price trend has surged to a new peak, with both London spot gold and New York gold futures experiencing an eighth consecutive day of increases. London gold soared to a peak of $2,194.89 per ounce on March 8, while New York gold reached a high of $2,203 per ounce in consecutive trading sessions. That's all for today's Qingqiao Morning News. Thank you for listening.